United States Senators. We actually are on that side of the building. You're on the House side here, and that's the Senate side over there. And I'll just share a couple of things with you that you probably didn't know, and maybe some of you guys. That is, there's a big difference. You will be Senate in the House. You'll be in the Senate. You're kind of a product of your committees. Every senator's on two standing committees. Mine, and I have seniority in both of them, are one is Environment, Public Works, that's all the roads, highways, and that kind of thing. And the other one is the Senate Park Services Committee. We just came from a meeting that started an hour ago with the chairman, I'm the ranking member of the Senate Park Services Committee, and the chairman, the ranking member of the House Park Services Committee. Our subject, nobody else knows this, was what are we going to do about the little disarming of America? You guys are here at a time, and I know you don't know this, and most adults don't believe this, but we have a president that has been disarming America. I can give you all kinds of details. I know you guys are more knowledgeable than most people your age, and you're interested, or you wouldn't be doing what you're doing now. But if you just look at what happened, this administration started 2 years ago, did away with the only fifth generation strike vehicle. That's the F-22 at that time, our lift capacity, the C-17, our future combat system, and then all the major things, which I won't even elaborate on because I know you didn't believe that is what they did. I think they're ground based interceptors out of Poland. That's the only protection we have on the East Coast. Anyway, that's kind of where we are right now. We have we've gone through this before. We are now approaching, and we have a new hat right now, arguably, a hollow force. You ever heard that term before, hollow force? When you're reading about it, this factory in the 70s, we read that we had a hollow force. We had to then overcome that and start rebuilding your motor. That's where we are right now. I'd be very happy to answer any questions you guys have. I was on the phone talking to my son, because my grandson, and I was trying to remember which truth he was telling me. You know, that's what his affiliation is. Very interesting. All right, question.
Go on, right here.
Yes. No, wait. I'm sorry. Well, you know, there are terms that characterize people, not just in politics, but people in general. And some people think they're dirty words. They're not. It's liberal, conservative. A liberal believes that the government should be bigger and have more control of our lives. A conservative believes the government's already too big and already has too much control. We have a very liberal president, more liberal than any in the history of this country, who doesn't have a strong feeling about the threat that this nation's under. There are people in government now, extreme liberals, who don't really think you need any great service. They're all nations in the same service. Yes, sir.
What would you say is on our country's top priority to fix or to do right now?
Top priority is what?
To fix or create, or laws.
Okay, now are you talking about in defense?
For immigration, for debt, for...
Oh, I see.
Biggest issue.
Okay, well, let me give you a couple, the two that I am more directly involved in. And I see that Jim Bridenstine is here, your House member, and they have a different answer. Mine would be twofold. Number one, defense. If you read the Constitution, I'm classified lower than anybody else in the Senate as being the most conservative member of the United States Senate. But I hasten to say that I'm a big spender in two areas, defense and infrastructure. And that's because if you read the Constitution, that says what we are supposed to be doing here. Theoretically, that's why we're up here to take care of defense and infrastructure. So those are my two top priorities. Comes straight from the Constitution. I've said that many times on the floor. Are there others that you may get from Congressman Bridenstine or those of mine? Any other questions? Yes, sir.
Do you have a threat?
Well, the threat, yeah, let me just give you one. This is not the answer you would expect. That's not the biggest threat. The biggest threat to us right now is Iran. Iran, and our intelligence has, since 2007, has said that Iran, by 2015, will have both a weapon and a delivery system, and it can reach the United States of America by 2015. That's 2 years from now. And that's why we have to be involved in Egypt, for example. We have to support the military in guys have been talking about USSR, those were the good old guys, because that's what he knew what they had, they knew what he had, and they knew the original construction. All right, you guys, I know that Congressman Bridenstine, our new bright shining star in the delegation, is here, and he's going to share all of his wisdom with you. So settle down, and it's going to take a while.